A very good morning, dear students. Now let us start our social science class. Already in previous class we started chapter 15, globes and maps, and we discussed what is the globe and what is the map. And the maps are, it is very essential for us, and the maps it is giving more details, a small areas with a more details it is giving to us. So the maps are very essential, and we can see many different types of maps are there. And the maps, we can see the political maps are there, the physical maps are there, and the thematical maps are there. And we can see what is the political maps. In the picture, you can see that the political maps, it is the political boundaries of a state and a country. We can show the political maps, that is the political maps. And when we are looking the physical map, it is a physical features of the place we can understand, or we can see in the physical map. And when we are looking at the thematical maps, it is a specific information we are getting, or the theme, we can see a theme or the specific type of information, that is called the thematical map. So these are the different types of maps we can find out, the political maps and the physical map and the thematical maps. And already I told that the maps, it is a very essential for us and very useful for us. And we can see the essential components of the map. If we want to know about the in the maps and or what we are, if we want to understand more deeply about the maps, we want to know the essential components of the map. The essential components of the map, it is including the directions, the distance, the scale, and the signs and symbols. This all it is including in the essential components of the map. If we know this all, we can easy to understand the maps, or we can read the maps. So the first we can see the directions. Without the direction, if we want to read or if we want to understand about the maps and all, there the direction is very important. So we want to know the directions, and in all the maps we can find out the direction. The top of the map, it will be north, and the down part, it will be the south, and the right side it is east, and the left side it is the west. This is the directions we can find out. Dear students, you can see here. And you know that the earth rotates around its axis, and it has the two poles. The two poles are, it is fixed point. They are taken as north and the north point and the south point. And when you draw the line from the north to south pole, then the right side it is the east, and the left side it is the west. This is the from when we are looking, when we are drawing the north to south, and the right side it is coming the east, and the left side it is the west. And we can understand these four points, it is known as the cardinal points, the north, south, east, west. These are the cardinal points. And we can see again the intermediate direction. The intermediate direction means it is coming near between the north and east, the northeast, and the between the south and east, it is the southeast, and between the south and west, it is the southwest, and between the north and west, it is the northwest. These are the intermediate, direction, the northwest and the northeast and the southwest and the southeast. These are the intermediate directions, and the north, south, east, west, these are the cardinal points. So with this direction we can understand the maps. Next we can see the distance. You know what is the distance? The distance means the space what it is having between two places, that is called the distance. The distance is the space between the two places, that is called the distance. And there are the short distance are there and the long distance are there. And normally we will say the market is near to your house and the school is far to your house. So the near it is having the short distance, and the far it is having the long distance. And we can understand the distance, it is related to the time, and it is varying from the person to person. So maybe some persons, they are slowly, they are walking, the distance we can understand it is according to the, it is varying from according to the person to person. So the time it is not giving an idea about the distance. So we have to use, or we need to use, the system of measuring the distance and the surface of the earth. And in our country we are using the metric system, in which the long distance are measured in the kilometers and the short distance it is measured in the centimeters. And we can understand, or we can see the map distance and the ground distance. And the map distance, it is the distance between the two places on the map, it is measured in the straight line, it is called the map distance. And the ground distance, this also the distance between the two places, it is the on the ground, it is called the ground distance. The map distance, it is the distance between the two places on the map. And the ground distance, it is having the distance between the two places on the ground, that is the ground distance. And we can see the scales, there are the scales. The scales are the ratio between the map distance and the ground distance. It is called the scale of the map. The scale, it is the ratio between the map distance and the ground distance. It is the scale of the map. And you can see here, there are many ways to representing the scale on the map. The three ways are here. First one by a statement, and second one by representative fraction, and the third one by a linear scale. And when we are looking at the by a statement, we can see that in this method the ratio or the scale is states in words such as the 1 cm to 1 km. 1 cm it will be 1 km. And we cannot draw if we are having the 10 km from your house to school, means that all we cannot draw in the map. So we are using the statement 1 cm is equal to 1 km. 1 km it is the ground distance, and the 1 cm we are drawing in the map, map. So this statement, it is 1 cm is equal to 1 km. And when we are looking up the second one by a representative fraction, it is known, or it is abbreviated as RF. And in this method we can see the ratio is given in the form of a fraction, and whose numerator is always like 1, and like this 1 up to 1 lakhs. In this case we can see the numerator 1 represent the map distance, and the denominator, it is the 1 lakh, it is showing the actual distance or the ground distance. This 1, it is the map distance, and the 1 lakh, it is showing the ground distance. And again we can see the linear scale. In this method also the map distance is shown with the help of a straight line, we can see. And generally it is drawn with the title of the map. The title of the map, we can see this, the lines, and the line, it is divided in some parts, and the further it is subdivided. So the distance on the map can be easily measured. So these are the three ways it is representing scale on the map. The first one by a statement, and second one by a representative fraction, and the third one in a linear scale. Next we can see the signs and symbols. There is not enough the space to draw the signs and the actual signs and shape of the bridges, like bridges or the forest or the dams or the roads and roads. So we are using some signs and symbols, and without these signs and symbols it is not getting more information. So we are using some signs and symbols. And what are the signs and symbols? It is the internationally it is accepted, that is called the conventional symbols. You can see here some signs and symbols are here, and the common signs and symbols, it is the internationally accepted one, and already I told that is called the conventional symbols. And when we are drawing the maps, when we can see the maps and all, if we are drawing in the maps, if there is the post office, we cannot draw as it is the post office there. So we are keeping there the PO. So by seeing that we can understand there will be a post office. And the temple, this is a sign of temple. And the trees are, we are drawing like this, and the grass are like this, and the rod, the metal like this, and the rod unmetal like this. And like these symbols, when we are using, we can understand by seeing that map, we can understand that there is the rods, and there is a grass and trees and the temples and all. By seeing or by using these signs and symbols, we can very easily we can understand the map. Next we can see the sketch. We can say that, for example, a new student, he is coming to your classroom, and you want to show him the neighboring bookshop and all. So what you will do, you will draw a rough diagram, or you will say that you have to go from here to, you have to turn the roads and all, and you have to turn from here, and this all the rough diagram what you are drawing and showing, that is the sketch. And we can say without having any actual distance or the exact distance is not there, and the directions are not used, and the signs and symbols that also not used. Without using this all, what you are drawing the sketch or the rough diagram, that is called the sketch. So thus we can say that the sketch is a map with outline drawn without a scale or the also without a signs and symbols, that is called the sketch. So what is the sketch? The sketch is a map without having a signs or symbols, or without having the scales, what we are drawing, that is the sketch. And what is the plan? The plan, it is a small areas, it is showing the minor details, that is called the plan. For example, we can say that if you want to draw the plan of your classroom, it is a small area, and all the details, the minor details also, it will be there. Even the how many doors are there, and the windows, and the blackboard, and the desk, how many desks, and the chairs, and the benches, and all this, all it is showing there, and this all details we are getting from the plan. And we know that the maps, it is representing the large area, and it is giving the it is drawn in the small scale. It is the large area, it is drawn in the small scale, and we can say 1 centimeter map, maybe it is representing the 100 kilometer, the plan. So it is the plan, it is the representing the small area, and therefore it is drawn in the large scale, that is called the plan. And we can say that there are the each one, it is having their own advantages. And the map can show a large area but without details. The map is showing the large area without having any details, and the plan can show the small area but great details. The map is without any details, and the plan, it is the small area and very, it is giving the more details. And the sketch can be, it is drawn quickly to give a rough idea. It is very quickly giving the rough idea. So this we studied from this chapter. We have seen the globes and maps, what is the globes and maps, and the types of maps we have seen, and the essential components. There we have discussed about the directions, the distance, signs and symbols, and the sketch and the plans. This all we have seen, or we discussed from this chapter.